Welcome to the Google Ads API Best Practices series. My name is David Will, and I'll be your guide on improving the efficient and effective use of the API. Let's get started. Welcome to Retrieving Information Efficiently, part of our Best Practices series. We're going to cover three use cases. The first case is simple. You want to retrieve properties and metrics of a given entity. The second use case is reporting, where you want to retrieve historical information, and that can return a lot of rows. The third use case is about syncing. That's where you want to grab all the information about a given account and keep a local copy so your application runs faster. One of the great things about the Google Ads API is that you can use the same interface for all three use cases. There are three methods for retrieving information: SearchStream, Search, and Get. SearchStream allows you to retrieve an unlimited number of rows with a single request. The result is all streamed back in a single response, which is why it is called SearchStream. Because it is very efficient, it should be the default method that you use. It is especially valuable for large downloads. But there are cases where search is the more appropriate method. Search retrieves one page at a time. A page is an arbitrary number of rows from as little as 1 up to 10,000. You should always set the page size to the maximum of 10,000 unless you are severely memory constrained. The client libraries handle pagination automatically. As you are going through the sets of rows and reach the end of the page, the next page will be automatically requested behind the scenes for you by the client library. If you are using the REST API, you have to handle this pagination yourself. What's also interesting about paging is that each page has a unique token associated with it. If you store that token, you can go back and retrieve a previous page. There are two common scenarios of using search. The first one is if you have an unstable connection. Let's say you are downloading 100,000 rows, and the response in SearchStream keeps breaking. You would have to start the request again from the beginning. If you use smaller chunks, like paging the response via search, then you can simply retry a given page that has failed. The other scenario you use search is when you need to go backwards. Let's say you've downloaded a lot of rows to display in your application, but too many to store all at once in memory. In that case, use the page token and retrieve a previously downloaded page. Let's see how this works. When you make a search request, the Google Ads API retrieves the results from the database and generates the entire response, and then puts that response into a cache. For the first and every subsequent response, the results come from that cache. The cache will live for 2 hours. If a page is demanded, the timer gets reset, so another 2 hours can elapse before the next page is requested. Eventually, the cache will be removed, so don't take too long to download all the pages. Now that we've seen how the results come from the cache, let's look at how to use the page token to go backwards. The first page that you get back contains the number of rows you requested and a token for the next page after that. You must always store the first page because there is no next token for the very first page. When you retrieve the second page, you will get a token for the third page. Just to make sure this is really clear, let's run through a quick example. You're downloading row 25,000, which is in the third page, but you need to go back and retrieve row number 15,000, which is in the second page. Because you are already on the third page, you have received the token for the fourth page, so store that token. To go back, issue a new search request specifying the token of the second page. After you have retrieved the second page and want to go on, do another search and specify the fourth page token. Let's talk about when to use GET. GET is specific to one service. GET retrieves all the properties and all the metrics of a given entity. It is a very expensive operation, as some entities have dozens of properties and metrics. Because it is expensive, a given developer is limited to only 1,000 GET requests per day across all accounts. GET should only be used for development and debugging purposes. It should never be used in production. Let's recap. SearchStream is your default. If you're not sure which method to use, use SearchStream. Search is for special circumstances, such as unstable connections or needing to go back to an earlier part of the response when you can't store the entire response in your server's memory. Each page is limited to 10,000 rows. GET is for debugging and testing only. It is never to be used in production. It retrieves only a single entity, including everything about that entity. With Search and SearchStream, you must be explicit about which properties and metrics you want to retrieve. If there's one best practice to remember, use SearchStream by default. Stay tuned for more advanced sessions in our best practices series. We welcome your questions and feedback via email, and thanks so much for listening.